Hello, welcome to another edition of School Spirit. I'm your host, Lisa Remick. Well, all of the schools have been very busy since the end of the winter break. George Mason High School has been working on another International Baccalaureate Forum. Former GM students who had participated in the IB program are now on hand as volunteers to answer questions from students who might be interested in taking International Baccalaureate classes. Let's take a look at how that went.
In a word, basically, very briefly, I'll go from one end to the other. Would you say that your IB experience at George Mason did a good job of preparing you for college, for university, and life? I mean, how do you feel about it? Stacey, would you like to? It's an overall comment, because we're coming towards the end now. It's only about another 8 minutes. So you can sum up what your IB experience was at George Mason, and whether you feel it's been truly formative.
I would say my experience in the IB program, what I got out of it was what I learned, and I enjoyed most of the classes. I enjoyed what we were learning. And I found that when I got to university, I was maybe more well-rounded than I could have been, or maybe more than I needed to be. But if you plan on taking it, I would consider that it is, I found it very stressful. It was a lot of work. But if you want to put that into it, then go ahead. It's a great experience, even though it is really difficult. But if you don't really want to work that hard, if you're not going into it for the right reasons, then I wouldn't worry about it, because it was good for me, but it's not essential or even very important to do the full diploma.
I think that my experience with IB was overall a positive one. It definitely made me more knowledgeable about myself and my surroundings, not necessarily just about like how I think or how I learn the best, but also about the world and how other students deal with the subject matter in different ways. And I just think that at our school especially, there's a lot of pressure to do the IB diploma or even to take a few IB courses, but it all depends on yourself. And I know that we're all saying that, but it really does. You have to evaluate yourself. You have to see how much challenge you want to put yourself through these next 2 years. I'm assuming most of you are sophomores and juniors. It definitely was a good experience for me. I felt really accomplished when I could say that I did the IB diploma. And I'm not saying that it definitely put me above most of my peers, but it prepared me well for college.
Christina? Yes.
Same for me. I felt really, really well prepared to go to college. I felt like I knew how to manage my time, and I knew which ways that I learned best, and that helped me with my studies. But one thing was that IB forces you to make a lot of choices, and some of those choices you regret, and some of those choices are, you know, the right choices that you make. But I would probably say that the most important thing is to make the choices that you want to make. Don't make your choices because all your friends are doing IB or whatnot. And I think because I thought that at the beginning, there was a lot of pressure for me to take these IB classes, and then I just came to the realization that, you know, I need to be doing this for myself, and I need to take courses that I want to take instead of the courses that I would have to take to get a diploma.
Andrea, how did you feel about your IB experience? Because Andrea did part of her IB in Lisbon, and then came to us at a fairly late date.
I think that the IB for me was the best program, well, if not, I guess, the only option. And I don't know how many people are in a similar situation in which you might move or switch high schools during high school, but if you're in that situation, then I would highly recommend doing the IB, because academically it makes that transition a little more smooth. And so as for choosing to do the IB or not at Mason, my recommendation would be to at least if you're not sure if you want to do the diploma, at least take IB courses, because I would agree with the other people up here that have spoken that I feel that taking IB courses, and in my case doing the diploma, has well prepared me well for college and just prepared me well in general and made me a well-rounded person, and I think it's a good program.
Richard?
I started the IB diploma program for completely the wrong reasons. I started it because my parents wanted me to do it. They wanted me to have, you know, the highest possible, you know, courses that I could take and stuff like that. And I was kind of resentful at first, but then as I took the courses, I started to realize that this really was what I wanted to do. I did want to challenge myself. I did want to learn how to manage my time. All the stuff the IB was providing me, I wanted for myself. And it has ended up really helping me in college. My first semester was not extremely difficult because I knew how to manage my time. I knew how to study. I knew how to take notes. And that's something that IB really does teach you. Plus, in the courses, you do learn some very valuable material, and it's not as controlled as the AP is and kind of limited, and it's more like a free, open learning environment, and I really enjoyed that about it. And so overall, I think my experience was pretty positive.
Lisa?
I moved mid-high school as well, except I came in my sophomore year. So my old high school was much easier than George Mason, than the IB program was, and so like I still keep in contact with some people from my old high school, and like I've seen how much the IB program and George Mason has given me in the way of like how prepared I was for school, and how because they did IP and because the school was a lot easier, that although they did well in school, they didn't learn the time management skills and the sort of self-discipline that you really do get from the IB program. But again, like everyone has said, do it for yourself. Don't do it because your peers are doing it. Don't do it because the school pressures you or your parents pressure you. Because even if you're just taking one course or if you're doing the whole diploma, do what's right for you. Because really, you don't want to be in these courses if your heart's not into it. Because you're going to get stressed out and you're going to, it's just going to make your life much more miserable. But if you're in it for the right reasons and if you're in it for yourself and you're pushing yourself because you want to, it's going to make it a much better experience. And you're going to get more out of it academically and mentally and everything.
Caitlin, do you want to add to that?
Yeah.
Can you tell us?
I definitely feel very well-rounded after the IB program. I feel very well-prepared for college. I know that I've proofread some of the papers of my peers and just been like, wow, okay. and helping them and stuff like that, like using simple things that like we always did in IB, like not using personal pronouns. I mean, they never learned this, so I feel like instead of AP, like you come out, instead of like just learning how to take a test, you come out just very well-rounded. And like in contrast actually to Richard, my parents didn't want me to do the diploma. My mom came back from Ms. Sinha's parents' night and sat me down and said, please don't do it, you're going to kill yourself. And I did it anyway, kind of like my mom didn't think I could do it and I kind of did it. And I mean, I feel proud that I did it for me. So, I mean, basically the same thing, like, go ahead.
Okay, through the IB diploma, I really found my major for college. I did higher level biology. And it was through that course that I really found out that I wanted to do biology as a major. So I think that's one thing I really took away was like finding out who I really wanted to be. But also, when you go to college, a lot of my orientation was like them saying time management. Because it seems like a lot of kids who go into college don't have that. And I sat there and I wanted to kind of laugh because we had gone through all of this and it seems kind of almost like preschoolish to have to go through that whole like them lecturing us about time management again. So I think it really prepared me for college, and I think my transition was much more simple than I had anticipated.
Yeah, like I would agree with that. I think that like most of our transitions to college were not, I didn't think that it was scary. In fact, I thought it was easier going, you know, into that year than it was going into junior year, because I thought that junior year was the most work I've ever done in my life. But my recommendation to everybody would be to take IBH English as like, you know, even if you take nothing else, because I think even if you hate English, that will teach you how to manage your time. Like I thought that class alone, you know, taught me how to, you know, manage my time and do my work and all that good stuff. But keep in mind though, if you want to do the IB diploma, you don't have to take the same like regimen that everybody else does. Like I did not take IBH history, I did not take IBH math, I just found things that worked for me that could, you know, fulfill the requirements. Like we have other courses at George Mason that can do the same things. Like IB Anthro or, you know, IB Math Methods. So just kind of sit down and like think of what classes you actually want to take and see if it'll work for you.
Finally,
I believe that IB program just helped me to be above my peers in college right now, because when I came in, I saw like the first month, let's say, everybody was stressing out because they did not have enough time to study, and I had nothing to do because everything was done already. I was just sitting in my room doing nothing. And the first class, when I came to my writing class, I was really surprised because when my professor said that we were going to be writing a 10-page paper and we have an entire semester to do it, everybody got like freaked out because they never wrote papers that were longer than 5 pages. And so like, yeah, I would agree with Mary, definitely take English and it will really help you just to write.
To learn more about the International Baccalaureate Program at the Falls Church City Public Schools, please contact Brian Dixon at George Mason High School, 703-248-5500. Well, our next stop is TJ Elementary. The students at Thomas Jefferson Elementary School in Mrs. Shaw's fifth grade class have been pretty busy. Not only did they create another Continental Congress, but they also took care of voting on a Declaration of Independence. Let's see how that worked out.
The Second Continental Congress meeting in the city of Philadelphia is now in session, July 1776. The Honorable John Hancock of Massachusetts, Bay, President.
The chair recognizes the distinguished delegate from Virginia, Mr. Thomas Jefferson. On behalf of the Virginia legislator and Richard Henry Lee, I move that these United Colonies are and ought to be free and independent states. And these states should now dissolve all connections with Great Britain, form a plan of confederation with each other, and take steps to secure foreign alliances.
It has been moved and seconded that this Congress debate and vote on the independence from Britain. We are ready to debate and vote on this issue. I will now recognize the delegates who will speak to this motion. The chair recognizes the distinguished delegate from Massachusetts, Mr. John Adams.
Mr. President, Mr. Hancock, fellow delegates, you know that I am John Adams of Massachusetts. We Americans are at the crossroads. No people at any other time in history have faced a more important decision than we do now. It is a decision for all Americans to support. I am not a great Greek or a Roman orator, but I make up for my own lack of equivalence with my passion for this cause. Gentlemen, the king has refused to remedy the great and heavy injustices we have suffered. That has been so nobly expressed in Mr. Jefferson's work. George III has ignored and rejected our humble petition, and at the same time, sent armies and navies to crush us during our attempt at liberation. We colonies should now declare to the world the reasons for independence, such as we will bring allies to our struggle and unite us. We have no time to lose. If we postpone independence, as Mr. Dixon, we will most certainly suggest, we do not consent to be conquered people. Instead, we shall fight. We shall fight with whatever means we have, with rusty muskets, with broken flints, with bows and arrows, and if need to be. But, gentlemen, we shall fight. And all I can say is, I have crossed the Rubicon, and I stake everything on this cause. Sink or swim, live or die, live or die. I survive or perish with my new country. This is my unalterable resolution.
Mr. President and fellow delegates, I am Samuel Huntington from the wonderful colony of Connecticut. Sirs, I serve the king as his honorary in my home colony. I still feel some loyalty. Having said this, let me merely bring up the taxation issue and say no time did I feel overburdened with taxes, at least no worse than what our comrades in England pay out. I hope that this entire ordeal is not over taxes. As for me, I'm willing to pay them for British protection and other advantages.
The chair recognizes the distinguished delegate from Maryland, Mr. Charles Carroll.
Mr. President and fellow delegates, I am Charles Carroll of Carrolltown, Maryland. Living in America has been good to me. Frankly speaking, I am rich, beyond rich. Yet, I have been a critic of Parliament's acts and crippling taxes. I even predicted armed rebellion. Still, I am wondering as we prepare to break away from king and country, if the British system hasn't made life better for us than for people living in Europe. The economy, the economics opportunities we have here are perhaps unique. Should we continue to rebel against policies that have made us prosperous? Consider my words of caution. I vote yea.
Distinguished delegate from North Carolina, Mr. Joseph Hughes.
Mr. President and fellow delegates, I'm Joseph Hughes from North Carolina. At one time, I needed to be convinced on this independence issue, but now I am an enthusiastic supporter of it, especially after knowing what other North Carolinians are thinking. I believe we also need to settle on a plan for Confederation government at this time. Further, my country is entitled to my services, and I shall not shrink from her cause, even though it should cost me my life. I am disappointed the reconciliation seems remote. But let me finish by saying I have furnished myself with a good musket and bayonet.
Thank you. The chair now recognizes the distinguished delegate from South Carolina, Mr. Arthur Middleton.
Mr. President and fellow delegates, I am Arthur Middleton from the colony of South Carolina. Gentlemen, I'm usually bored with the routine of this body when I'm here, but now it is time to take a stand on the real issue, independence. I hate the loyalists. How any American can support that fat German sitting on his London throne is beyond me. He and his ministers are incompetent nincompoops, and they are incapable of ruling us. As Mr. Payne has so eloquently written earlier this year, thank you for listening. I vote yea.
Thank you. Mr. Secretary, what are the results on the vote for independence?
The vote to separate from Britain to form our new nation is 18 votes in support of the proposal and 1 votes against the proposal. The measure is adopted. We are a new country.
Thank you, Mr. Secretary. Gentlemen, we are a new nation. I will now read the fifth grade version of the Declaration of Independence. Announcement of freedom by the representative of the United States. When it is necessary for a nation to separate from one another, they will have to make their own decisions to put their troubles behind them and protect the environment while using their natural resources. Everybody is made equal from their creator, and they all have the right to be happy and free. We want to keep these rights among us. The people have the right to get rid of the government, if they choose. The new government is allowed to make or get rid of the old laws. If the new government does a bad job, the people should give it a chance before getting a new government. Instead of someone else being in charge, we should try to make our own form of government. The king refused to let us make our own laws. King George III also refused to make needed laws for the colonies. He won't let the colonial governors make them emergency laws. If they are in the middle of something, they cannot make laws without his consent. He ignores the colonies unless we give up the idea of a colonist representation in Parliament. He is talking about the laws and saying, I, King George, will make the laws and you can't do anything about it. We should be able to make our own laws and we will not give up. The king has refused to let us make our laws, so we assign people a job to take care of things. He won't let us elect our own governors. We are shipped to England to be tried. We could be invaded at any time and England won't help. England does not want people to move to America because it will make our country bigger and stronger and we might break away from England. King George said he's in charge and we cannot do anything about it. He has made our judges dependent on him for the rest of their term and the rest of their salaries. King George appoints our officers and issued the Quartering Act. He sent his troops to our offices and homes, and the men told us what he wanted. The king is not letting us have peace. Large groups of troops are attacking us. He has put the military down above the laws. He is ruling us with virtual representation. The troops are tried in England, and they are usually pardoned. We can't trade with anyone but England. We are unhappy because we cannot trade with the rest of the world. We have been taxed without our consent for our representation in the Parliament. We also do not get trial by jury. They will have taken English laws and put them into the colonies. By getting rid of our important laws, by taking away our documents, England is declaring that they have more power to make our laws at all times. King George is not protecting us because he said we are not loyal to England. King George has burned down our towns. He has killed our people and this time is sending Hessians over to attack us. He has tried to bring on the people of our frontier and the surrendering Indians who fight and destroy people of all ages, including women and children. He has incurred revolts of our people. He took away our property. He has forced a horrible war against us. King George has broken the most important right of life and liberty by allowing Africans to be caught and sold into slavery and letting the slave trade go on. He has rejected the law to stop the slave trade. Now he is telling the slaves to fight against us to get their freedom. We have tried to ask King George to protect our rights, but he has answered by injuring and killing us. You are trying to rule over us, but we cannot come here, but we came here to get freedom. We have reminded the king of coming here to get away. You killed our people and taken away our money, and you are still rich and powerful even without us doing this. You continue to crush our government as we were trying to build it up. You continue forcing the king on us, but we don't want them. We too are deaf to the voice of justice. You are disturbing our people. English can freely vote, but you vote for our officials for us. Right now, you are letting your officials send over soldiers that are our friends and allies, and also sending foreigners to kill us. You are not caring for us, so why should we stay with England? We want to restrain England as you restrained us. In war, we are enemies, but when we are fighting, we are friendly in peace. We used to be great together, but now what you consider nice is a big no-no because it is in your dignity. We can be happy without your ruling us, so we can be separated at any time. We Americans assembled in the Second Continental Congress, and we do, in the name of all these colonies, and by authority of the states, reject all political connections with the King of Great Britain. The states now have the power to do as they wish like any other country. We support the Declaration with our lives, our money, and our honor.
The tsunami that hit Southeast Asia has touched and affected so many of us. Students at George Mason High School wanted to show that they were profoundly saddened by the event. So they worked together with staff, administrators, teachers, and parents, and they organized a special day where they could raise money to help those who had been affected by the tsunami. And here are some of the highlights of that day.
The principal made an announcement in the morning when we came back from winter break, inviting anyone who was interested in working on tsunami relief to attend a meeting. We had about 70 students and staff show up to that meeting, which turned into about an hour and a half long brainstorming session. From that, this project was born.
It's got like a standard silent auction. say your name, ID number, bid, and stuff?
We didn't really know what to expect when we put this thing together, and the kids really drove the whole event.
My children and I wanted to come help support.
We donated a big vacuum and a little baby toy.
It's a teachable moment for all of us, I think. I think it's a good time for us to be reflecting on what we have and what privileges we enjoy, especially at a time when there are folks in Southeast Asia right now who are suffering as a result of the tsunami.
The day that we came back from break, we talked all about the tsunami and what caused them, and looked at some of the humanitarian pictures and satellite pictures from the Washington Post.
Everybody at school really came together and donated all this stuff, and so we're selling as much as we can, and all the funds are going to the Save the Children Fund, and everything that we don't sell is going to go to the Salvation Army.
They were really quiet. They were very quiet and thoughtful about the fact that so many people had lost whole families and family members, and a lot of kids were orphaned, and, you know, so I think they found a way to relate, even though this is all the way around on the other side of the world.
They just have the can-do attitude, which means they're learning from this, but we all, I think, as a community, learn as well.
We've gotten so many donations from all these different corporate companies as well as individual people, and
thank you.
It's turned out really well.
It's just been phenomenal.
We couldn't have asked for a better turnout of stuff for the white elephant. It's just amazing.
And ladies and gentlemen, we would like to thank all of you for your support all through this week. Monday night we started here with a jazz concert and raised $2,400. And during the week, some more contributions came in. Today, we raised about $19,000 for a grand total for the Tsunami Relief Project of just over $25,000.
For the community to come together like this to address humanitarian needs is something that we all should be very proud of. So on the part of Save the Children, I thank you very much.
What we have agreed to do as a school is to keep the focus on tsunami relief for the remainder of the school year, because we all know that the children who are in need in the Asian countries that have been affected, their needs are going to persist.
With the efforts that you just saw, George Mason High School students very proudly raised more than $32,000 to help the victims of the tsunami. We're very proud of their efforts. As we close our show, it's budget time again at Falls Church City Public Schools. If you would like to attend a public hearing or a work session on the fiscal 2005-2006 budget, a list of those dates and times will be coming up shortly. For more information on the Falls Church City Public Schools, please check out our website at www.fccps.k12.va.us. Thank you very much for watching this episode of the School Spirit Show. I'm your host, Lisa Remick. Good night.